sun is shining, the birds are chirping, the bacon is sizzling. Welcome to the Daily Swole.
Going Glitterbeard today for the beginning of 465. Welcome to the Daily Swole. Thanks for joining me live every day at 12 noon Eastern Time right here on Facebook. Thanks for watching on YouTube and listening to the SoundCloud and iTunes podcast. Remember, you can catch every single episode on SoundCloud and iTunes. What do you guys think? Should this actually be a thing? Should this actually be done? Like, should I do this? I think this should be done. You like that? Looking good. Glitter beard. Glitter. Looking sassy. The crowd goes wild. Welcome, everyone. No, for sure. Some people are fans. Some people, not so much fans. Unicorn. I do look like a unicorn with this beard. Can I change colors? No, I can't. No. It's not that. Ain't that high tech. It's not that good. Welcome, everyone, to episode 465 of The Daily Sleazy. Today is coffee for fat loss. Coffee for fat loss. And this week for The Daily Swole, this week for Papa Swolio, we are going to hammer a bunch of major topics about nutrition, about diet. And this Thursday night, we've been doing a lot of fitness stuff, a lot of exercise, a lot of demos. This Thursday night in Premium is going to be nutrition workshop. So the topics are gonna be broad, the topics are be in depth, and we're gonna start here with coffee because I always talk so much about coffee, and I got my coffee, I got my cup, I got my backup so I can refill my coffee. But let's talk a little bit about what you've seen me drink a lot. I always talk about, you know, the popular butter coffee that's been growing popular, but I've been doing it for like 4 or 5 years. It's grown to more popularity, but there's a lot of stuff that comes in my inbox about coffee and about putting butter in the coffee and why I do it, why I prefer to do it, why I drink coffee. And there's a lot of good things, a lot of benefits about coffee. Now, when you go into nutrition, when you start talking about nutrition, we start discussing nutrition. What's going on, Van? Thanks for joining. First timer, everyone. Say hi to Van, first timer. Yeah, float some hearts and definitely comment. Let's start right there. If you're new to the show, if you're new to the Daily Swole, make sure if you're a new watcher, drop a comment. Tell everyone that you're new and then we'll welcome. We shall welcome thee. We shall flex. Oh, did I not introduce it properly? That the Daily Swole is the most muscular swolecast in the realm because when I flex, you flex, we all flex the biceps. I just felt like flexing again. Let me do a double one. Yep. Yep, there you go. There you go. That's for all the noobs. That's for all the noobs, the flex. So whenever you start talking about nutrition, you're going to get a lot of people that have, you know, you're going to have a lot of people with nutrition that have a one-track mind. Like, this is the only way to do things. This is the only way to do things. That's the only way to do things. Well, I have a specific process in hammering down your own personal nutrition, and that's something that I'm going to get into on Thursday's workshop. We're going to go over the next couple days, today, tomorrow, Wednesday, here on the Public Daily. We're going to talk about nutritional concepts. We're going to talk about some things that are, you know, maybe popular in the media or I get a lot of questions about, because when you come to me, when you come to Papa Swolio, that shows me what's on your mind, and that shows me what's on a lot of all of your minds. Because if three people ask me the question, chances are there's 300,000 people out there that have the same question that either just don't ask it or, you know, assume the answer. And when it comes to nutrition, when it comes to any kind of diet plan that's very individualized, we have to understand a couple things. One, that we're all human beings, so we have a lot of similarities, okay? We have eyes, we have faces, most of us have faces, we have arms, we have legs, some people have vajayjays, some people have pee-pees, you know, everybody poops. We have the same, like, we're generally the same, right? Human beings are generally the same, but there's a lot of individualities. So my approach to nutrition is similar to my approach to fitness, is that you have to learn things for yourself. And it's very, very important. There's not a cut and dry way to do anything. That's why you're gonna have some people that are adamant about doing a specific type of exercise training. Well, it obviously works for them, and they maybe know other people that it works for. Does it work for everyone? No, of course not. Nothing works for everyone. So with every approach, with diet, with fitness, with everything, there are always different directions to success. There's different pathways. There's different people that will have different opinions, and there's different roads to the same destination, just like anything else. You want to go to the supermarket, you can go east and then come back around. You can go straight to the supermarket. You can go over here, go through three lights, take a back road, go in the back entrance. So you always have a few roads to your destination. And that multiple roads to success, I think, gets lost. I mean, we get programmed. And let's start here before we get into the coffee. Maybe I should have retitled this episode, but we'll get into it. That when it comes to learning and education, we're taught there's one way that's right and one way that's wrong. We're taught this math equation is this way and everything else is wrong. You know, I saw, you know, there's a great video going around, you know, or there's a few videos like this where there's a right answer and then there's all the wrong answers. Like there's no gray area. There's no like, well, this could be right because in many ways it's a better answer, but this is the right answer. You know, it's like multiple choice. A is correct. B through E are just wrong. They're not partially right. They're just wrong. So we're taught with school, we're taught with education, the classic form of education, that there's a right way. I mean, float some hearts if you agree with me. We're taught that there's a right way, and this is a little philosophical, but we're taught that there's a right way, and then we're taught that there's wrong ways. So there's a right way to eat, and there's all the wrong ways. There's no like, well, this is good, well, this is good, well, this is good, and this is, you know, not so good. It's always, this is the way, and the other way is a highway. Same thing with religion. Like, you believe one thing, everyone else is wrong. Your stuff is wrong. You know, the way I exercise is right. The way you exercise is wrong. When I believe in God and everything that you believe is wrong. When I believe in politics and you're just wrong. It's stupid. We're brought up in this society where there's a right way and then everything's wrong. Like, there's no like middle ground, right? So when it comes to things like nutrition, there are, in my opinion, better ways in general. I mean, I think we would all agree that soda doesn't have a place. Like, it's just wrong. And yes, Nick, that's called bioindividuality. We're all the same, eyes, ears, feet, hands, but inside we're gonna be different, which is why some people get near a peanut and they fucking die, and other people eat a jar of peanut butter and they feel fine. And then you have everyone else in between that might have a little stomach indigestion, maybe have a little bit, retain some water. You know, there's like allergies and intolerances, and we'll get into this tomorrow more. So today I titled this about the coffee because I wanted just to talk about the coffee. I wanted to have a, you know, a sharp topic and just kind of discuss a little bit about it. But tomorrow I'm going to talk a little bit more about the proper approach to nutrition, some different aspects about it. And on Thursday, in the premium workshop, again, the sign up link is in the description here, gonna break down literally, you know, what I believe is just the best approach for you to come at your nutrition. And I will tell you right away, because some of you ask me, you know, hey, do you have diet plans? Do you have meal plans? I don't think that's appropriate. I don't think that's appropriate. I don't think that's safe. I don't think that's wise. I think that's lazy. And I think that's risky by anyone, any of these fucking online trainer bullshit people that are offering meal plans, because you're not teaching people anything. You're giving caloric restricted diets. Okay, right? You're restricting calories. You're giving protein based on a number multiplied by their body weight. Very arbitrary. Like, you don't know anything about the person. You don't know how much muscle mass they have. You don't know how much fat-free mass they have. You don't know about their, you know, life history. You don't know about their genetics. You don't know about their family history of XYZ disease. Yes, Sarah, our world is not black and white. There's a lot of things that, you know, you have to be aware about someone before you start telling them to eat 6 ounces of chicken and half a cup of white rice and some broccoli. It's like, how... Not that that's bad for many people, that can work fine. And I think we keep on going down this road where that's just been accepted as the norm. Like, chicken, broccoli, and white rice. Because honestly, in general, those foods have very low reactions for most people. Like maybe 80%, you know, standard deviation, the bell curve. Most people in the middle are going to fall between, they're not gonna fucking break out in hives when they have chicken breast. They're not gonna break out in hives when they have broccoli. They're not gonna have cold sweats and joint pain when they have white rice. It's just, those are not highly allergenic foods. But then it starts spreading, right? It starts spreading because then we create this mentality that there is a, right? That there is a, how should I say it? That there is a cookie cutter way, that there is a, okay, eat this, eat this, eat this method. And then it spreads to other types of foods, and it spreads to other types of meals, and it spreads to, oh, add this and have 7 almonds and then this. And you start getting into foods and people start purchasing diets. And I'm not saying these diets are bad, and I'm not saying these foods are bad, because, and this might blow some minds, but just because a food is good does not mean the food is good for you. And that's the bio-individuality that was commented by Nick earlier. It's called bio-individuality. Almonds might be healthy, but for some people, you're gonna have a lot of fucking digestive issues, and people are gonna have nut allergies. So how healthy is that for John? You know, Mike can maybe eat a pound of almonds and feel fine, and then John has 5 almonds, has the shits, and has bloating and stomach cramps all day. So how healthy are almonds for John, you know? It's like, does it matter if they're healthy, if the FDA approves almonds, or does it matter that John is eating something that his body is having a violent reaction to? So that's my concern with nutrition. And that's why when I talk about nutrition, I like to use the adage, I want to teach you how to fish, I don't want to feed you. And it's ironic we're talking about nutrition, but it's important that you learn how to fish. It's important that you learn how to feed yourselves, because it's gonna go far beyond what I can just give you, oh, eat this, eat this, eat this. You have to learn how to analyze. You have to learn how to listen to your body. You have to learn how your body reacts to things and start paying attention to who you are as a person so you can make the proper decisions today, tomorrow, next week, next year, and so forth. So that's the important thing. That's the important thing, learning how to teach yourself. Learning how to teach yourself. You're welcome, Justin. I hope you enjoy it. You have to learn how to teach yourself. You have to learn. Does good nutrition help grow a beard? I'm sure it does. I mean, it comes from your body. Certain foods and nutrients, I'm sure, will help grow beard hair longer. Will it take you from bald to... That's the magic pill right there. So when it comes to coffee, let's start here. I know that was a little bit of a rant, and fuck, I mean, that could have been a whole different episode already. But one of the reasons why I like coffee, first off, if you're drinking a quality coffee, you know, a quality coffee is going to have a lot of antioxidants that are good for, you know, eliminating some of the crap that, you know, circulate through our bodies. So, I mean, antioxidants are literally, you know, it's a chemical reaction that helps eliminate bad things in your body. And coffee's been shown, and, you know, caffeine, a lot of things, benefits brain health and longer life, and studies that show countries that drink more coffee are healthier and so forth. We all know the short-term effects of coffee, but what if you can make coffee healthier? What if you can make coffee more nutritious? And that's one of the things that I've been doing for the last few years, and that's one of the things that a lot of you ask me questions about, what do I put in my coffee? And I am one of those people. I put the grass-fed butter, MCT oil, and there are even additions you can put into coffee like cinnamon, like bone broth and bone collagen and other elements that can increase the healthy fats, that can increase the benefits and the nutrient benefits from your coffee. So it makes it more of a cup of fuel rather than just a cup of caffeine. So it really, doesn't. You know, it doesn't replace, turmeric, all those things. It doesn't replace, you know, food. That's not what we're talking about here. But we're talking about a method of adding and using nutrition to your advantage. So if you've heard of ketosis. You've seen some other episodes on ketosis, on high fat diets that are beneficial for people that are, you know, maybe insulin sensitive, that have sugar issues and sugar imbalance issues, are looking to lose a lot of weight. You know, high fat ketosis style diet and lifestyle can be very beneficial. So one of these choices, like a high fat coffee recipe, can be very beneficial for helping rebuild the joints, for helping repair things in the intestines. I know, like, my technical terms, I'm being a little bit vague because we don't need to get into the exact details right now, but as a result of improper nutrition and allergenic responses, the inflammation in the gut and the intestines, healthy fats, things like collagen, things like bone broth, and these kinds of proteins that could be put also into you know, your morning cup of coffee with, you know, supplementation and healthy powders, can help repair damage that has been done in your system. So coffee to aid fat loss, Velveeta cheese in her coffee. That just stopped me on the dime because that's gross. But using coffee and using nutrition to your advantage is something that could be beneficial to you if you're looking to lose weight, if you're looking to help yourself out, if you suffer from things like diabetes, if you have issues with, you know, blood sugar. But again, this is very individualized. So I wanted to do this episode that kind of spread onto the general philosophy of nutrition, but also come back to coffee because I've been getting lately a lot of things like, hey, you drink a lot of coffee, what do you put in your coffee? And it just seemed like Monday is a good day for a coffee episode. And we'll get more into this, you know, later in the week, and I'll break it down. I'll explain a little bit more. Like I said, nutrition workshop this Thursday in Premium, and gonna really break down the principles and the approach to setting up your diet and setting up your nutrition. There's grass-fed Irish butter. Are you talking to me, Mark? I already got that in my coffee, bro. I already got that, so you know it. But yes, healthy fats, things like conjugated linoleic acid, CLA, that's found in things like grass-fed butter. Healthy fats and healthy medium chain triglycerides, which is what MCT oil is, and it's an extract from coconut oil that's beneficial for brain health, for metabolism. It's beneficial for energy usage by the body, especially if you're doing something like a high fat ketosis style nutrition plan, which teaches your body to utilize fat for energy and ketones and so forth on the scientific side. So, for example, coffee can aid fat loss, and so can other things, you know? And I wanna use this as like a two ends of the spectrum, because you have, let's say, us having this conversation about coffee for fat loss, and then you have cookie cutter diet, caloric restricted, you know, the classic, you know, chicken, rice, blah, 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 you know, one piece of toast, this, that, and the other. Which one's right? Well, this might be more right if you have a lot of gluten intolerances, if you have a lot of digestive issues, if you have a lot of digestive repair that you need, if you have a lot of weight loss to lose. This might not be correct for you if you have gluten intolerances, you know, the piece of toast, if you have wheat allergies, if you have issues with eggs and you have and you can't digest eggs well, because eggs are a very common allergen. So the cookie cutter, which hand am I using? The cookie cutter diet, you know, the classic caloric restriction X, Y, and Z, that could still work. You could still lose weight when you do a caloric restricted diet, but you could have inflammation. You could have joint pain. You could be restless sleeping. And what happens with someone that's doing a caloric restricted diet, that is having trouble sleep, that is having restless sleep, that doesn't feel good in their joints, they're less likely to stick to the diet, they're more likely to overeat because they're not sleeping well, and cortisol levels will be higher, and imbalances in glucose in the brain, and they'll be more hungry late at night, and it causes them to binge eat and fall off their diet. You see what I'm saying? So not always will a nutrition plan work just because it's caloric restricted. So things like coffee, things like high fat coffee, things like butter coffee, MCT oil, collagen, bone broth, those types of healthy fats in and proteins in coffee, because there are, you know, collagen powders you can use, and there is, you know, bone collagen powders you can use, and there are, you know, cinnamon you could add to the coffee, which is very healthy. Yeah, and Gina, you hit her on the head. You know, the healthy fat, and then people talk and fats get popular again, right? Oh, fat's good for you. And then you have paleo brownies and then caveman bake off. Yeah, and you have, but then you get the people that are trying to market it. Then you get the people that are trying to capitalize on the fad, right? But is it a fad? Is any of this actually a fad? Is this a fad or is it just a different way of eating? Is being vegan wrong? No, I don't think it's wrong. Is being a vegetarian wrong? I don't think it's wrong. I don't think it's right for me. But I could never say, oh, human beings shouldn't be eating meat. That's ridiculous. I think that's absolutely absurd. As much meat, maybe. Bad kinds of meat, antibiotics and poisoned meat, I don't think anyone should be eating that. So you have truths to both sides, but it's the extremes where people fall. It's the one-track mind. It's the idea in society that there's a right answer and a wrong answer. And everything you're taught from when you're 3 fucking years old up through college is that there's a correct answer on the test and there's a wrong answer. Actually, that's incorrect. That there's a correct answer on the test and everything else is wrong. Okay? There's a correct answer. That's what the United States does. That's what the world does. Right answer, everything is wrong. So if there's 100 million answers, one answer is correct and all the other answers are wrong. How much sense does that make? Zero. It makes zero sense that there can't be any gray area, that there can't be any mix and match. There can't be any half and half. There can't be any in between. So you have to understand how to think for yourself, how to apply for yourself, and how to systematically eliminate things out of your nutrition that are bad for you. How to figure out how to do that, how to even approach that, how to know if you did eliminate something that was bad for you or if you eliminated something that was good for you and you could still eat it. And that's what we're gonna be covering the rest of this week. That's really what I'm gonna hammer home this Thursday night for the nutrition workshop in my premium group. So I encourage everyone to sign up, to join. Still waiting for that new release for premium. I'm super excited about all the updates, but the first things first, Nutrition Week, this Thursday workshop, going to explain everything about approaching your nutrition, how to approach your diet, things that I personally do that I recommend, and the best way, in my opinion, to approach your food and how to figure out what's right for you. Because if you don't find out what's right for you, it doesn't matter. You need to figure out what's best for you, not anyone else. Not me, not James, not Mike, not Karen, you. You gotta figure out what's right for you. So this is a big week. And thank you so much for joining me for episode 465. I hope you enjoy your coffee. We'll talk more about bulletproof coffee, butter coffee. It goes by a bunch of different names, but there's the high fat approach, and there are ways to improve and to work on reducing body fat the proper way. There are ways to reduce body fat the smart way. There's ways to reduce body fat the healthy way. And there are ways to do it the cookie cutter way. And I highly, highly recommend, encourage all of you to approach it the healthy way, the proper way, the way that's best for you. But we have to look at you. We have to look at the details and look at the approach and how you're approaching your nutrition and do it one step at a time to make sure that you are not eliminating good things and you're eliminating all the bad things that don't work for you. So that's a little bit about coffee. That's a little bit about my nutrition philosophy, nutrition approach. A lot more this week. Remember, nutrition workshop in premium this Thursday at 8 p.m. You could sign up with a link in the description. Premium workshop and access to all the workshops that I've done before, the shoulder workshop, core training, all the other ones before. So it's going to be awesome. So if you're already in premium, very excited for this week. It's going to be huge. Thanks for joining me for episode 465 of the most muscular Swolecast in the realm. Because when I flex, you flex, we all flex. Our biceps. Every day, live at 12 noon Eastern time here on Facebook. Catch all the episodes on YouTube. And you could also listen to the podcast on SoundCloud and iTunes. keep an eye out, everyone, in your emails. Keep an eye out, everyone, for your emails, because this is the final week for the special offer of my 90-day fitness program. The special offer for the exclusive community is ending this Sunday. So make sure you jump on that. Keep an eye out for your emails, or you can message me if you want any details. It's program.soulnormous.com, but I will also give you a little bit more. I'll send you a link if you're interested in the 90-day program, but special offer ends on Sunday, but I'll be hitting you all up in the email to give you some more details on that. So if you haven't jumped on it and you need help with your training, if you need help with the details and specifics of what to do on what day, and you need to start something right away, message me, check out that link that I just dropped, and check out the 90-day dash program. There's also a link here on the Facebook page. But peace out, peace McGee's, deuce McGoose. I'll see everyone tomorrow for 466. We'll make it 466 tomorrow. All right. I miss having the numbers there. I totally do. Peace out. I will see everyone tomorrow. Premium. I'll see you at 1 p.m. Premium for the accountability meeting. So I will see you the most amazing program in Zarel. Thank you, Baz. I appreciate it. I'll see everyone in Premium at 1 p.m. for the accountability meeting. Later, tomorrow, 466. Peace out. Eat healthy.